guys, this is Nathan, and welcome back to FDB Beyond from the Creedcraft server. So, I live streamed a whole bunch yesterday on putting dirt on this mountain, and then I worked for a couple hours afterwards on putting that dirt down, and I didn't really get too far. This is a very long and intense process, but the results are phenomenal. So it is definitely worth it. Now, one thing that I had commented on when I was in the live stream was thinking I might want to go to a texture pack. I have been running the vanilla textures, but I'd kind of like to get a decent texture pack. If you guys have any suggestions of one that you'd like me to try, I would love to hear about it down in the comments. I want something that's at least a 32 by 32 texture, but I think I can handle something a little bit higher. But it's really starting to look nice. It's taken a lot of work to get it there, but there's a couple of things that have really been causing problems for me, and the biggest one is getting around with this slime sling and the glider. So we're going to remedy that today. So one thing that I have been trying to avoid in the last couple of modded series was making a jetpack. Well, I'm not going to make a jetpack. I'm going to be even cheatier than that. We're going to be making the Angel Ring from Extra Utilities. Now, this thing is not going to be easy to make. We need two nether stars for this. So we're going to have to kill two more wither bosses. And the problem with that is I have no skulls yet left. Yeah, man, I am stumbling over my words today. But so we're going to have to go and farm some wither skeleton skulls. And then also we have to capture a ghast in a cursed lasso. And this is a drop of evil with a golden lasso, and this is just some string of gold nuggets with 8 XP. It's pretty simple to make that. And then also we need to catch a bat. And we may have a little trouble finding a bat. We gotta go and find somewhere dark. Now there are a lot of dark caves underneath the mountain here, and there's a very good possibility we could find some down there. But we're gonna have to do a lot of resource gathering before we can make this thing. And then on top of that, it says that it uses 32 GP or grid power. Well, currently we are only generating 12, which means we are going to have to greatly ramp up our grid power production. And I think I am still going to stick with these solar panels. But that means that we have to make at least 32 of these solar panels, and because of the fact that these don't work at night, we are also going to have to make, and that's not what I wanted, I want extra utilities. We are also going to have to make, if I can find them here, the lunar panels. So these give the grid power at night, and these give it during the day. So we can get grid power regardless. So both of them say power reduced by rain. That really stinks. But it does also say these lunar panels have a power boost of at full moon. So that's kind of an interesting one. But we're going to have a minimum of 32 of each of these. Now, there are a couple other options for grid power production. Most people run with the water mills. Now, these things give 4 GP each maximum, and that is if you have a decent number of water sources around it. There's also the windmill that, it looks like we can generate about 1.7 currently if we were to put one here. There's also this fire mill, which gives 2 GP when placed over fire, so we could put some burning netherrack down, and that might actually be something we do a little later. Let's see, what does it take to make these? You know what? Actually, I think we are going to go with these fire mills instead of the solar panels and lunar panels, because these lunar panels do take this lunar reactive dust, which isn't really too bad to make, but it's just lapis. Lots and lots of lapis. And I have not been doing a lot of mining down at the lower levels recently. So I think instead we're going to go with the fire mills to produce our GP. We also have a lava mill. Nah, I don't really want to deal with that. But I think the fire mills would kind of look good in the dwarven area, because we will have open flames, and then we can put the fire mills in the ceiling or something like that. We could put something like big open torch sconces that have a burning netherrack in them, and then hide one of those fire mills inside of it, making a dual purpose item. But any way you look at it, I am going to have to head to the nether right now and work on killing some wither skeletons first. And actually, before we do that, I need to get the what is that? The cursed earth set up again. So, do we have some drops of evil? Yes, we have quite a few drops of evil. So we'll grab one of those. Looks like I have a few mob drops here to drop off. But we have some dirt. I think we're gonna, well, this should keep dirt supplied in our inventory for us. So before I go, I will need to chunk load this area. Okay, I do have it chunk loaded, so that will continue to supply me with dirt while I'm in the nether. But we are also going to be taking along a sword that was created. I can't remember who created it. There is a sign on the chest that it sits in, and it is a beheading sword. So that will give us the wither skeleton skulls a lot easier. But also, I am wanting to see if we can get a ghast to spawn, and wow, the lag. Ah, Avnir. Or Avinor. But, so yeah, we have this guy here, beheading 5. I think that gives a 100% chance of giving us a skull. But we're gonna take this with us. We're gonna have a drop of evil. We're gonna try making the, cursed earth spawner for the ghast, and yeah, I will be back in a little bit. So I'm back here at the site of the cursed earth farm that I had made, or mob spawner, and I modified it a little bit. First thing that I did was to make it smaller. Now this make it a lot easier to light it up, if that will stop spawns, or just removing the cursed earth. Just in general, that will be a lot better. Now, another thing that I did was to put spikes up here above, and I guess I can put blocks behind that. So the idea here is that these will deal damage, and actually, that is not quite the right spot. I need this to allow wither skeletons to go through, but not to allow magma slimes. So the large magma slimes, I need them to be damaged as they are coming in here. So we're going to reduce the spawning surface even more. So wither skeletons should be able to very easily get in here, but the large magma slimes will get killed by these iron spikes, and they will shrink down and come down here close enough that we can kill them with our sword. Now, the next thing that I did was putting a stone brick wall and a nether brick fence here, and I'm hoping that will stop the small slimes from coming through. And also, I am going to go like that. So this will give us a place to hide if we need to from Blaze. But I think I'm ready to give this thing a try. Now I'm gonna leave this side open so that I can attack through there. I'm gonna get the cleaver here in my inventory, or in my hotbar. We're gonna hit this with the cursed earth. And there we go. That should, yep, we already have zombie pigs being spawned. There's Blaze, and I see skeletons. So this should work just fine now. I don't think we'll have any issues with mobs trying to attack us. And yeah, I'm going to just do my best to get some Wither Skeleton Skulls here. And then we may take a look at modifying the other box spawner that Apache built with Cursed Earth to get ghasts a lot faster. Well, I was going to modify this box over here to catch a ghast, but I think we're going to do this the old-fashioned way and glide around the nether and try to catch a ghast. So, not an easy task, but I think that might be the best way to do it. So, right now, there are no ghasts in the area, so I'm not sure where I'm going to find them, but we are going to just glide around here. This glider moves extremely fast, which is the only real advantage to it over the other one. But, yeah, I'm going to glide around, see if we can get a ghast to spawn in, maybe catch some glowstone. That's a good thing. And, that actually... Oh, I see what's going on. Server lag. But, yeah, nothing really too difficult about flying around and trying to catch a ghast, so I'll bring you guys back once I've got it caught. Well, I had to hide from them. There's two ghasts out there. The problem is, I get this message. Ghast has too much health. 5 hearts. Reduced to 2 hearts. Which means we have to hit him once with our rapier. That's easier said than done. So, yeah. I've been kind of struggling with this for a little bit. And there's a nitro creeper over there. One of the worst things is, we're getting lava everywhere. And, yeah, this is... Ah! Nitro creeper. Yeah. And then I get stuck in soul sand, which is not good. Just in general, not a good thing. And then on top of that, we got lag. So, this is not going good. Okay, I hit him. Let's see if that was enough. Let's get back up here. Now we gotta try it. Yeah! What the heck? Okay. Did I get him? No. 3 hearts! What? I gotta hit it again. Oh! Well, that... At least I got a ghast here. Well, this may be a little bit more difficult than I thought. I'll figure something out and I will be back. So, we are going to try this a little bit differently now. So, okay, there's the ghast. So, I made up some soul vials from Ender.io. And what I'm hoping is that this guy will be able to pick up the ghast, and then we can transport it somewhere that will actually be useful for us. So let's see if we can hit him. Not like that, we can't. And why did we bounce so weird? Get down here. Oh geez, the fire here is terrible. We're too low. Oh, man. He's gonna despawn. We gotta get over there. I don't think we got him. No, the server lagged. No! Darn it! Darn server! What the heck is going on with the server? Perfect, come on! Oh, there's another one! Bounce! Got him! Okay, we got one. Let's see if we can catch the other one, because it never hurts to have the extra, just in case we happen to kill the first one. That's right. Keep going down. Keep going down. Oh, God, that is not a good place to be. No, it's not. And there goes the lag again. Okay, get over the ground. I don't know, we might have to let this guy go. I don't think he's gonna come over here. He's gonna run away. Well, I'll see if I can possibly catch him. What kind of a fuse wood? Oh, I don't want to mess with that. So I'm gonna see if I can catch this guy. And what the heck? This is irritating me. How is it? There was no fire there a second ago, and there was no gas blast. And now we can see there is just lag all over. Well, hopefully I can catch this guy. And I'll meet you guys somewhere else that maybe we can do something without this lag. Ooh, resonating crystal. So I managed to get two bugged out soul vials. Now these say they have a ghast in them, but you can't click the ghast back out. So I don't know, maybe we can use those in a powered spawner. I am not sure what we can do with those. I tried relogging and it still says that there's a ghast in those. But anyway, we are going to go ahead and do this here. Now we are just underneath our storage at the mountain base, but gas cannot destroy stone, so we should be okay here. So I'm gonna release this gas and then just punch it. And let's make sure that we're full of food. Okay, we may want to go down just one more block, because that is painful. So let's go ahead and let that kind of wear off. And I think what I'm gonna do is try to sneak up underneath him. Okay, so here's his tentacles. So he is trying to hit me now. So, every time we hit him, it's half a heart. It looks like he's at 3. Okay. There we go. We got him. So we have a ghast in a cursed lasso. So I'm going to go ahead and fix this back up. And then we are going to get that bat, which the bat should be a really easy one to do. And then I guess we got some withers to kill yet. So, I am going to get a few things done here, and I will be right back. So, I have captured a bat. I have also killed two wither bosses. So, we should have everything that we need now to make this angel ring. So, let's go ahead and do it. So, we need some glass, gold, two nether stars, resonating redstone crystal, the ghast in the lasso, and the bat in the lasso. So here's the ghast, and here's the bat, and there we go, angel ring. So now, if we come over here and look at this, it's going to say that we are not generating enough power, I think. So for a second, it will allow us to try to fly, but that's not working. So let's take a look at that mill now. So we want to make the fire mill. These guys aren't too bad to make, so we need the stone burnt, but I think we are going to want, well, no, we should be able to do this. So let's go ahead and clear this. How much stone burnt do we have? We have 25. Actually, that might be enough. So we just need to make some of these redstone gears. How many of these can we make? Yeah, we'll make 10. And let's see. How many? Three. We ran out of the resonating redstone crystals. Ooh. So we can make these with ender shards and redstone. These guys take a glass cutter. I think we're just going to go ahead and do this because we desperately need these. So we'll make up one of those. Yeah, that glass cutter will last a very long time. So there's eight more of those. And four. Okay, so that will give us some. So let's go ahead and grab that. And do we have a flint and steel? Not in here, we don't. Not in here, we don't. Okay. Well, we'll just go ahead and make one then. I always seem to make those, and then I didn't need to. So I wanted to make sure this time around. So this is going to give us eight more grid power. And actually, I think I'm going to bury these in the ground a little bit. So let's go ahead and grab our Terra Shatterer. The best part about this is we can hide these pretty easily. And now we will light this with the flint and steel. Let's go ahead and place a little stone back here so that we can start placing our fire mills. So, yeah, now we're generating 2, 4, 6, 8. So, need to sleep so that I can get the 12 more out of the solar panels, but I'm gonna have to make some more stone burnt so that I can make a few more of these fire mills, and then I will be back. So I have quite a few of these fire mills now. I have made 26 of them so far, and we are still making more stone burnt so that we can possibly make some more, but here's the big moment. We're flying. We are flying! Woohoo! That was a lot to do that, actually. So now we can actually just fly out here, and I'm kind of curious, will my hang glider actually work now? Well, I have to double tap spacebar again. But yeah, we can actually fly out here and look at the mountains, see what's going on. There's a really weird line going around there. I don't know what that's about. But, yeah, that is really cool. That is going to speed along the production of this mountain big time, because one problem that I've really been running into is getting up these slopes. They're just a little bit too steep to be able to jump, and so we need to be able to... Oh, okay, so slime boots don't do anything now. But, they're a little bit too steep to be able to jump up, so you have to use the slime sling to get up there, and then you sit there and bounce, and yeah, no fun. But, yeah, I am going to continue making these until we have this last line covered. That'd be six more of them, so at night we will be producing 64 GP, and then during the day that will jump up to 76. So I'm pretty sure we'll have a great deal, plenty of GP now. So yeah, I am going to get that done, and I'll be back. And so there we go, 32 of these fire mills. That is going to produce more than enough GP for us for quite some time. Now, like I said, as we get the dwarven base built and we put in fire for lighting, we're gonna figure out some way to hide these things right above that fire always, so that we can be using that for more than one thing. But a real nice thing here is we can take our slime sling and our advanced hang glider and drop those off in our pack, and we don't have to worry about them ever again. Well, hopefully not ever again. But yeah, that is real nice, and we move rather quickly, quick enough to caused the server to lag, that's for sure. So that is really awesome. But we are out of time for today, so I'm going to say thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to give a thumbs up. If you are new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. If you have any thoughts about what I've been working on or anything that I could work on in the future, be sure to leave that down in the comments, and I will see you next time. Bye!